Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. Before you start installing or upgrading to Windows 7, it is a good idea to understand the minimum requirements for Windows 7 and the different features each edition has. Even though the minimum requirements and editions are not specially stated in exam objectives, having an understanding of these will help you when installing and upgrading to Windows 7. If you are running Windows Vista, you will be happy to know that the system requirements have not increased too much. In a lot of cases, the only hardware upgrade you will need to perform will be the installation of more RAM. For the minimum requirements, you need a 1 GHz CPU, either 32-bit or 64-bit, the same as Windows Vista. The RAM requirements have increased since Windows Vista. For the 32-bit version, you need 1 GB of RAM, while the 64-bit version needs 2 GB of RAM. RAM is more affordable, so it is a good idea to purchase more. Windows 7 will use the extra RAM to increase the system's performance. You will need 16 GB of free space to install the 32-bit version and 20 GB free space for the 64-bit version. As with the RAM, the more hard disk space, the better. These figures are only for the base install. If you are planning on installing additional Windows features, the amount of hard disk space that you require will increase. Lastly, you will require a graphics card that supports DirectX 9 and comes with a WDDM driver. Nowadays, with DirectX 11 being the latest version and DirectX 9's last release being 9C in 2008, all video cards on the market should support this. To run the Aereo interface, Windows Looking Glass effect, you need at least 128 megabytes of video RAM. Microsoft does, however, recommend that you have at least 256 megabytes of RAM on your video card. In the real world, the amount of video RAM you need is determined by what resolution you are running. If you are running two monitors off of the one PC, you will need to double the amount of video RAM. For Aereo to run, your video card must also support 32-bit color and Pixel Shader 2.0. They are currently up to Pixel Shader 5.0, with Pixel Shader 2.0 being supported by Microsoft since the release of DirectX 9 back in 2003. So again, any modern video card should support these requirements. Once you have determined if your computer meets the requirements to run Windows 7, you need to determine which edition of Windows you are going to install. There are 6 different editions of Windows 7. As you go from left to right, more features become available. Those that are familiar with Windows Vista will remember that certain features were available in Home Premium, but were not available in the Business or the Enterprise editions. This is not the case with Windows 7. As you go through the editions from left to right, every feature from the previous edition is available in the next edition. The first edition is the Starter Edition. In the USA, this edition is only available on small notebook PCs. These small PCs usually sell for only a few $100s and are great for mobile users who only want to access the internet, write documents, and send emails. The Starter Edition is the only edition of Windows 7 that does not support 64-bit processors. Since it is aimed at a general PC user, graphical applications are not included, such as DVD support and the Aereo interface. The next edition is the Home Basic Edition, and is available only in emerging markets such as Brazil, Thailand, and Mexico. 64-bit is supported, but like the Starter Edition, only one CPU is supported with any number of cores. There is some support for the Aereo interface, but certain features of the Aereo interface have been removed. The next edition is the Home Premium Edition, and is aimed at the home user market. This edition supports more features a home user would want, such as DVD playback and the Media Center. Also, the Aereo interface is included in this edition. The Professional Edition is the first edition aimed at the business market. Not only does it include all the previous features of the other editions, but it adds domain support and the ability to install more than one CPU. Remember, however, all editions support multiple cores if your CPU has them. Support is also included for Windows XP mode. Windows XP mode allows a program to run in a virtual Windows XP environment and seamlessly interact with Windows 7. If you have an old Windows XP program that does not work with Windows 7, you may get around the problem by using XP mode. The last two editions are the Enterprise and Ultimate editions. Feature-wise, these editions are identical. They include support for App Locker. App Locker allows you to enforce which applications are allowed to run on your system by creating an approved list of applications. This prevents users from installing applications that they may not have licenses for. The feature BitLocker allows you to encrypt your hard disk so that if it is removed from the computer, the hard disk cannot be read. This helps to stop your data from being used if a laptop or computer is stolen. Since these editions are aimed at business, support for direct access is also included. Direct access allows a computer to automatically connect to a company's VPN without any interaction from the user. This means the computer can access updates and group policy without the user having to log in. This is a great feature if you have a lot of mobile users. Next is support for virtual hard disks. Those who have used products such as Hyper-V will know that the virtual machine's hard disks are stored in a VHD file. This VHD file can be copied or moved to another computer and used by another virtual machine. For those of you who did not know that, now you do. Windows 7 Enterprise and Ultimate Editions allow you to create a virtual hard disk and store the VHD file on your existing hard disk. You can even boot Windows 7 from a virtual hard disk stored on your local hard disk. This is a great feature if you want to dual boot your system. Dual boot simply means installing more than one operating system on the same physical computer. Later in this course, I will look into dual booting in more detail. Using a VHD file means you no longer have to partition your hard disk or add an additional hard disk if you want to dual boot your system. Lastly, these two editions support Branchcache. Branchcache allows a Windows 7 computer to cache files that were copied over the wide area network. This means that if another Windows 7 computer attempts to access these files, it can retrieve them from the cache rather than copying the files over the wide area network again. Feature-wise, the Enterprise and Ultimate editions are the same. The actual difference between the two editions is the way they are licensed. The Enterprise edition is only available to customers that use Microsoft's volume licensing. The Ultimate edition is available via retail. The last thing to consider when deciding which edition of Windows 7 to install is how much memory you want to use. If you are using a 32-bit system, the most RAM you will be able to use is 4 gigabytes. Note, however, if you are running the starter edition of Windows 7, this is limited to 2 gigabytes, while all the other editions are limited to 4. One thing to keep in mind if you are running a 32-bit system with 4 gigabytes of RAM is that the computer will not be able to access the entire 4 gigabytes. In my experience, a system with 4 gigabytes of RAM generally can only access about 3/4 of the RAM. This occurs because hardware installed on the computer must also have its RAM mapped out in the 4 gigabyte space. The biggest user of this is generally the video card. Since two devices cannot access the same space, the system can only allow one, and thus the total accessible RAM on your 32-bit system with 4 gigabytes of RAM is never really 4 gigabytes. If you are running a 64-bit system, the amount of RAM you can access changes quite a bit. The starter edition is not available in a 64-bit edition. The home basic edition, available in emerging markets only, jumps to 8 gigabytes. The home premium edition supports 16 gigabytes, which is more than enough for the average home user. All the rest of the editions support 192 gigabytes of RAM. This is plenty of RAM, and you would be hard-pressed to find a motherboard that could support that much RAM in today's marketplace. But believe it or not, motherboards that support this much RAM do exist. Once you meet the minimum requirements for Windows 7 and you decide which edition you want, you are ready to install Windows 7, which is the topic of our next video.